this is Chloe McCracken. Today I'd like to share with you a tapping video specifically designed for mums, but hey, if you want to give it a try and you're not a mum, then that would be fine too. And it's about finding calm when everything seems to be changing. And this felt like something quite appropriate as we near the end of the summer holidays and kids go back to school. And they might be starting a different class, they might be starting a different school, whatever. There's a lot of change in the air right now. But you can equally use this tapping video any time of year, really, because I think with kids, things are always changing. It's like, who's their best friend? What's the thing that they want to have? What kind of food do they like? What kind of food do they hate? It seems like things are always changing, and it can feel really hard to keep up with all of that. And just when you feel like you've got a grip on what's going on with your child, they've changed again and you have to come up with something new. And that can feel really quite stressful and hard to manage. So this tapping video is to help you with that. So take a moment first to tune in to yourself and see just how much are you feeling that kind of pressure or stress at the moment from all the change that is going on. And you might rate that on a scale from 1 to 10, where 10 is, I'm so stressed, I'm tearing my hair out. And 1 is, actually, I feel pretty calm and peaceful, and it's not a problem right now. So take a moment to think about how that feels, and maybe jot it down, because it can be really interesting to see how that perception changes after you've done a little bit of tapping. So now that you've written that down, you don't need anything except your fingers to tap along, and you can just say what I say and tap where I tap, repeating back, so that we're tapping along together. Let's give it a go. Even though everything feels like it's changing so fast, and I'm not quite sure where I am, I deeply and completely love and accept myself. Even though things keep changing and I can't quite get a handle on it, I'm here and I'm okay. Even though things with the kids change all the time and I just feel like I've got whatever it was and now it's changed again, and I have to rethink things, I have to change my perspective, I have to change the way that I'm acting, I deeply and completely love and accept myself anyway. All this change, and it feels like it never stops. I've just gotten used to something, and there it goes, it's different again. Just when I feel like I've got a handle on things, it's different, it's changed. All of this change, this constant change. And sometimes I feel like I'm constantly running just to keep up, or even just to stay in the same space. And it feels exhausting, and it feels confusing, all this change, this constant change. And I have to adapt, because I have to be there for my kids. And I have to try and keep up with what they're doing, with their likes and dislikes, with what makes them happy and sad. Why can't it just stay the same for even 3 months? This constant change, and I'm not sure where I am or where I'm going. And I'm open to the possibility that maybe this could be easy. I'm open to the possibility of finding a different way. I'm open to the possibility that I could just stop running. That maybe if I find my calm, my center, then from that place of calm, I can dip back into the maelstrom of life. I can dip back into the chaos of the everyday. From that place of calm, I can respond to what I find there in the moment, rather than playing catch up with what I thought should be there. So I'm going to take this time for myself, even if it's just 5 minutes, to find my inner calm, knowing that from this place of calm, I can respond much better. And I can find the right way for me in this moment to find that calm centeredness. And it might come from something practical like doing the dishes or writing a shopping list. I might find that mental and emotional calm through physical movement, going for a walk or a cycle, dancing. I might find that sense of calm through gaining a bit of clarity, perhaps by journaling. And I might find that calm, that emotional resilience, through my connection with others, taking some time to talk with a friend, or just stop for a cup of tea together. And whatever feels right for me now, I will make the time for this, for me, knowing that it will help me respond better to the crazy hecticness of life with kids. Lovely, and take a deep breath. So check in with yourself. How are you feeling now after that round of tapping? Perhaps think again about that rating of 0 to 10, where 0 is completely calm, 10 is tearing your hair out with stress. And where do you feel now? Notice if it's gone up or down. Sometimes it might go up if you're focusing in on something that you've been kind of pushing away and not acknowledging. Oftentimes you find that it will go down with these little tapping meditations. And whether it's gone up or down, you might choose to do another round of tapping, either following this again from the start or doing some tapping by yourself. I hope that this will help you find a greater sense of serenity.